That was Indian Army, tanks, soldiers, paratroopers, all working together in that military exercise in Ladakh. A very important message being sent to one of our neighbors there. As they say, the more you sweat in the peacetime, the less blood you lose in the wartime. Hello and welcome. I'm Ankit Tyagi. Now let us take you to our top story. The clamor for Pakistan-occupied Kashmir is growing in India. From ministers to army, everyone is now talking of retrieving Pakistan-occupied Kashmir. But the boldest statement came from External Affairs Minister S. J. Shankar. Take a look at this report.
A day after the government revoked Article 370 to end Jammu and Kashmir's special status, Home Minister Amit Shah reaffirmed that Pakistan-occupied Kashmir was an integral part of India.
मैं जब जम्मू एंड कश्मीर बोलता हूँ, मान्य सदस्य इसलिए aggressive हूँ कि जम्मू एंड कश्मीर के PAKO को आप भारत का हिस्सा नहीं मानते हो क्या? Aggressive ना हो, जान दे देंगे इसके लिए. क्या बात कर रहे हो आप? Aggressive होने की क्या बात कर रहे हो? जान दे देंगे इसके लिए.
Shah's assertion set the ground for other top ministers to renew reclaim POK pitch. Defence Minister Rajnath Singh was the first to follow up.
आगे भी जो बातचीत होगी किस मुद्दे पर बातचीत होगी? अरे बात होगी अब तो पाक अधिकृत कश्मीर पर बात होगी बहनों भाई और किसी मुद्दे पर बात नहीं होगी. हमारा पड़ोसी बड़ा आतंकवाद का सहारा लेकर भारत को अस्थिर करना चाहता है, भारत को कमजोर करना चाहता है.
Kashmir. The next day, it was MOS and PMO Jitendra Singh spelt out a virtual roadmap to annex Pakistan-occupied Kashmir.
Now the next agenda is retrieving PAK-occupied Jammu Kashmir and making it a part of India. और ये सिर्फ मैं नहीं कह रहा, या मेरा संगठन नहीं कह रहा, ये राजनीतिक दल नहीं कह रहा. This is a part of a unanimously passed resolution of the Parliament in 1994 by the Congress government headed by Prime Minister Narasimha Rao.
As the clamour grew stronger, Vice President Venkaiah Naidu too joined the bandwagon.
Kashmir is an integral part of India. From 1952 onwards, 54 onwards, elections are held. Chief ministers are elected. There is an elected government at the state. Members of parliament are being elected. And what is there now to discuss? Yes, there is something remains to be discussed. I do agree. The remaining thing to discuss is about with our neighbor is hand over the remaining part of Kashmir to us, that is POK.
And now, External Affairs Minister S. Jaishankar made the most direct POK pitch, hoping that India will one day exercise control on the land.
We'll always be very clear, POK is part of India, and we expect one day that it will we will have the physical jurisdiction over it.
After its historic move on Jammu and Kashmir, is POK next on Modi government's agenda? Will it impact looming India-Pakistan face-off at UN next week? Bureau Report, India Today.
Let me introduce my guest this evening. Amit Malviya, spokesperson of the BJP, is joining us this evening. Kuldeep Khoda, former DGP, Jammu and Kashmir, also with us. Umar Altaf, Pakistani journalist, is also joining us on the broadcast. Good evening, gentlemen. Thank you so much for being with us on the show. I would like to start with you, Amit Malviya. This completely changes the way India has so far been talking about Jammu and Kashmir. Every time there was, India wanting to talk to Pakistan about terrorism, they would insist on Kashmir. Yes, now the goalpost, even the play field, has been changed by the Modi government.
Well, first of all, I think the comment today made by the External Affairs Minister is only reiteration of what has been India's long-held position. Since 1948, we have said that India has POK as its territory. And in 1994, the Houses of Parliament have passed a resolution to this effect. So clearly, India is very unambiguous in terms of how it views the illegally occupied part of Kashmir by Pakistan. And I think the External Affairs Minister has merely only said what is quite well known. Now, The truth of the matter is that for a very long time, India has had a very defensive foreign policy, which of course has changed under Mr. Modi's regime. We are not at all squeamish about where we stand and what our position is. And we've also taken the international community in confidence, told them exactly what the ground reality is. And today you have a situation where Pakistan has been boxed into a corner, and people are seeing merit in what India has been saying. So that's of course a big win diplomatically for the Modi administration, but it is certainly nothing new. It's a mere reiteration of the stated position with a conviction that's never seen before.
Umar Altaf, now this would in fact create a lot of problems for Pakistan in how they stand so far in Kashmir, and we have seen that coming in from within Pakistan as well. It was in fact the leader of the opposition there, Mr. Bhutto, who mocked Imran Khan. He said that previous governments used to talk about taking Srinagar. Right now the question that they are asking Imran Khan is, how do we say Muzaffarabad? This is now creating issues domestically and internationally as far as Pakistan's stand on POK is concerned.
I think the Indian External Affairs Minister S. Jaishankar's remarks on Azad Kashmir are a blatant attempt to shift the debate on Kashmir issue. India, which has imposed curfew in Indian-occupied Kashmir for the last 40 days and over, is just trying to divert attention because India hasn't been able to control the situation in Kashmir.
No, but
and now
Altaf
the U.S.
Sahab,
president and the world community is asking India,
what
are they trying to do in occupied
Kashmir?
Sir,
which world community? I just want to clarify, which world community? Which, can you please name the world committee? Your foreign minister has now been caught lying on Twitter. He said there are countries in European Union. I have the resolution of the European Union right now with me, where it has in fact gone ahead and condemned Pakistan, and they have also said it's a bilateral issue. Nobody else wants to jump in into it. United States is not standing with it. Prime Minister Modi is going to meet the Chinese president. The Chinese have very clearly said we are not even going to discuss Kashmir as far as the bilateral is concerned. So which world community are you talking about? Saudi Arabia, Bahrain have also
not spoken a word about it. I am talking about the UNHRC. I am talking about the concern expressed
by the UNHRC. In the end, you could not even move a resolution, sir. You did not have enough countries backing you to move a resolution. And UNHRC also reiterated it's a bilateral issue.
What difference as Jaishankar's statement makes? It makes no difference at all. You should remember there is no curfew and there are no human rights violations being committed by Pakistani authorities in Azad Kashmir.
Is that so? That's not what the UNHRC report, and also, by the way, the European Parliament said today. I will play that for you, but let me also
worry about the Indian jurisdiction in the Indian occupied Kashmir. If you were a legitimate force in Indian occupied Kashmir, there wouldn't have been a curfew.
I completely understand the frustration. I completely understand the frustration, but I would like Kuldeep Khoda to come in on this. Kuldeep Khoda, this not only signifies the change in position as the way the government wants to take forward the Kashmir issue. If Pakistan wants to talk, the talks now will be on very set parameters that India wants them to come onto the talking table, because apart from that, Pakistan has virtually no option.
Absolutely. But first, before that, for information of the Pakistani guest, there is no curfew in Kashmir. The only thing is that the terrorists backed by Pakistan establishment and Pakistan army are dictating the people at gunpoint not to open the shops, not to resume the public transport, and asking the children not to go to schools. As far as the government is concerned, listen to me first.
How would you feel?
I am sure that is something that a lot of people in Azad Kashmir, Gilgit Baltistan, Baluchistan, Khyber Pakhtunkhwa can tell you if you ask them. How do they feel when completely locked in the atrocities of the Pakistani army? Why don't you go and ask them? Why don't you go and ask the minorities, by the way, in Pakistan? A Hindu girl has also yet just been found dead in your country. You have absolutely no stretcher, no place to, in fact, to give any sermons to India. Amit Malviya, is this, should we see this as the declaration of the intent of the Modi government, or is it just political posturing? Should we see this as the next logical step by the Modi government, and how are we in fact now going to go forward with it?
Look, Ankit, I think let's first recognize that Pakistan's idea of building this utopian state based on religion is now coming apart, with the kind of human rights violation that we've seen in several areas of Pakistan, including Balochistan, the Pukhtwan region, the Gilgit-Baltistan, and other places. It's quite clear that for them, Islam is a very narrow view of the world that they seem to have. There are minorities within the Muslim communities like the Muhajirs, the Ahmadiyyas, the Shias, all of who are being persecuted. Now, if you look at the PoK, it was essentially a Shia-dominated territory, and Pakistan, through forced demographic change,
that
has actually settled a lot of Sunni Muslims there. And the result of that is that there is a lot of internal dissidence in the illegally occupied part of Kashmir. And what the external affairs minister merely said, that we expect that one day we would have jurisdictional control over the illegally occupied part of Kashmir. Now, perhaps we'll have to wait and see what the government does as the next step. But one thing is very clear, that we are absolutely sure about the fact that POK is what we are going to have the dialogue on. Anything else is an internal matter of India.
Absolutely.
Whether it is abrogation
of 370
or...
Umar Altaf, I would just like to quote to you what recently in the European Parliament, which your foreign minister, I don't know where he gets his information, but this is what the European Parliament has said. India is the greatest democracy of the world. We need to look at terrorist acts that took place in India, Jammu and Kashmir, which are propagated from Pakistan. These terrorists didn't land from moon. They are coming from neighboring country. We should support India. This is what has been said in the European Parliament. I would also like to quote, Pakistan is somewhere terrorists have been able to plan bloody terrorist attacks in Europe. Every big terror attack can find its roots in Pakistan. They are also calling you out on your human rights violation. Would the country not serve itself better if you only try and fix the problems within your country, which has become a state policy as far as Pakistan is concerned?
I think the UN, the EU and Amnesty International and the Western media has also called out India for its human rights violations in Indian occupied Kashmir. And let me tell you, Ankit, if India tries to raise the temperature, or even for the purposes of posturing, that your external affairs minister, your home minister, and your Amit Shah, if they talk about India's right on Pakistan-occupied Kashmir, what they call, what is actually Azad Kashmir, if India if India doesn't restrain itself, Ankit, I tell you, this would only escalate tensions in the region. And for that, I think it wouldn't be good for both the countries. So I think India should
stop
this aggressive posturing and smell the coffee and try and control situations.
The only problem is that we do smell the coffee. Pakistan possibly doesn't. Your oil reserves are down to 2 days. I mean, you can't even think of any escalation on the border. With Kashmir, your army has failed. You've been only talking about posturing every single day. Your people you are trying to push, including the bad teams, are being slaughtered on the LC when you're trying to push them.
How should the government of India go forward on this issue?
What
do you talk about?
Let Mr. Khoda complete his argument, Mr. Altaf. Sir, I don't know how things work there, but we like a civil debate. You made your point. Let him, in fact, make his point. I'll come back to you and raise some issues on Pakistan-occupied Kashmir as well. Mr. Khoda, go ahead, please.
J&K acceded to India under instrument of accession. So the legal position as it stands today is that J&K in entirety, including POK, is part of India, and that fact is not disputed at all. What Umar Altaf is saying is that Pakistan occupied POK illegally after aggression in 1947, and the UN resolutions or other things which Pakistan is talking about are merely future actions which should be taken or which are supposed to be taken, which have become completely obsolete in view of the demographic changes which have taken place in POK and Gilgit-Baltistan. Now, as far as legal position is concerned, like any other state of India, J&K acceded to India under instrument of accession, and legally it is part of India. So Pakistan has no position on J&K. So if India takes back its POK,
okay, gentlemen, I'm completely out of time on this, but I wrap up this debate, I just would like to once again, tell our guests from Pakistan, the British Parliament on March 23rd, 2017, has passed a motion which, in fact, after Pakistan illegally announced the attempts to annex the already disputed land of Gilgit-Baltistan, they have, in fact, recognized that Pakistan is illegally occupying the part of Kashmir which it calls Pakistan-occupied Kashmir. Sir, I'm sorry, you are isolated. Nobody in the entire world right now is standing with you on the Kashmir issue. If you want peace to come back to the region, the onus is on Pakistan to come onto the table, and the terms of engagement have completely changed. Amit Malviya, Umar Altaf, and Mr. Khoda, thank you so much for joining me on the India First debate. All right, now in yet another snub to Pakistan, and it is in continuance of other, in fact, setback for Pakistan, the European Parliament has bagged India on Kashmir, saying the issue is bilateral. In her opening remarks inside the European Parliament, Union Minister Thaithi Chuparianin has said that India and Pakistan should resolve Kashmir bilaterally, which is the rejection of Pakistan's demand of mediation. She also said the world cannot afford another escalation in Kashmir and the matter should be resolved peacefully. Meanwhile, other MPs in the European Parliament have hailed India and slammed Pakistan for terror attacks. Another European Parliament member, Fulvio Mastrosilo, has also slammed Pakistan, saying the terrorists were planning to target Europe. They are all, their roots are traced back to Pakistan. Joining us, very special guest this evening, Nina Gill. She is the member of the European Parliament. Ms. Gill, thank you so much for joining us on the broadcast. I quickly want to ask from you and understand what, in fact, the Pakistan has been seeking from the global forums, not only in the European Union, but also all across in United Nations and others. They have been facing snubs after snub. This time, what happened exactly when they tried to push mediation from the European Parliament?
Well, absolutely. Pakistan is trying to internationalize the issue, and the Parliament decided that we do not need to get involved. They're very mindful that this is a delicate situation and that it's a bilateral issue between India and Pakistan. That is what the Shimla agreement stated quite clearly. So, but Pakistan has been expending a lot of energy in trying to externalize and internationalize the issue rather than find a mechanism to deter terrorism from Pakistan into J&K, and also to try and address the huge violations, human rights violations that exist in Pakistan-occupied Kashmir and Gilgit and Baltistan.
Thank you so much, Nina Gill, for joining us on this broadcast. That's all that we have in this edition of India First. On the other side of this short commercial break, Rajdeep Sardesai with the top stories of the day and the biggest newsmakers.
Thanks for watching the video. For more such news and updates, please like, share and subscribe to India Today. Also, check out our other great videos from our channel. We know you will love to.